Welcome to Module 7, Nurturing Your Deal. Greetings from our Cape Town studio. Very good to be here.
That's right. Right by the sea.
Right by the sea. It's glorious weather outside. In this module, you're going to learn about nurturing your next big deal. Remember in the previous module, we talked about effective negotiations and how to negotiate your next big deal. Now you're on that cusp of you've reached verbal agreement to either you're about to sign the deal or you've just signed the deal, but you haven't yet mobilized for the execution phase. You're in that area. And we've discovered it's very important at this point to nurture your deal for various reasons. Doc, tell us why.
Well, I mean, what typically happens, and I'm sure you can relate to that, what typically happens when you have negotiated the deal, you walk out of that meeting with the deal almost in your hands, you walk on air, and then time goes by and you try and follow up and for some reasons your client is not responsive. Something has happened in the meantime that you think was out of your control, but there is a way to actually nurture the deal and to claim your control and claim your power.
Yes, it's almost you think you won the deal, but you haven't clinched it at that point. Now, there's various ways in which you can nurture your deal. And we're going to talk about how to unlock the power of LinkedIn through appropriate content marketing. You can portray yourself as the product provider or the service provider or whatever your business is of choice. And more importantly, give your counterparty, your customer, the confidence that they are dealing with the right people.
Now, many people struggle with this. They neglect or forget to nurture the deal. Why is that?
Well, it's often boils down to time. You know, we've negotiated the deal, pass that on to the documents department or your legal team to conclude it, and let me go on and hunt the next one. So you don't give it that little bit of care, a little bit of nurturing at the end. That's why we call it nurturing the deal. You know, it's about, that egg is about to hatch.
Now, I believe you just nurtured the deal online.
Yes.
On LinkedIn.
Absolutely, yes. Through targeted content marketing on LinkedIn and a request for a meeting with one of the managing partners, I found over the last week or so, this particular individual has been following us and these videos that we've been doing, our content marketing. And I realized ahead of my meeting, which is in a week's time, through the contents and the comments and the likes that have come through, it is clear that I have already pre-sold myself online. And that is the power of LinkedIn.
And especially content marketing on LinkedIn. So what are we going to learn in this module?
In this module, you will learn how to become a global thought leader. Why is that important?
Well, it is important for so many reasons. Remember today, LinkedIn has become the biggest publisher, bigger than any TV, any radio, any print media. And many people and many of your customers will go to LinkedIn, they will follow an industry, they will follow a channel, and they will follow influencers. And if you're not amongst those, now let me give you an example out of my own experience. Because of my content marketing, not only have I earned a million plus views on my content, on my LinkedIn content, in the last 100 days consecutively and consistently, but also what has happened is that people come to my LinkedIn channel, and many major leaders have told me that. They follow my LinkedIn channel and they come to my LinkedIn channel to keep up with trends and news in the industry and in their country.
Absolutely. So it's vital. You are most likely a subject matter expert in your area of expertise. Most of us are. Okay? Right. It's about how, through, as Doc is explaining, through targeted content marketing and putting yourself out there, you portray yourself as a global thought leader in that. What does this do? This gives, it builds rapport and trust with your client. Because like I talked about my example where I've pre-sold myself already, this potential customer has already got something to engage with me on. I saw your video on LinkedIn.
In fact, I've seen it so many times. that what it really does, it does pre-sell you, so that when you contact a decision maker or you have a meeting, they're basically sold. You don't, there's no more selling needed. All that's needed is to work out the details.
Is it fair to say, if you're an affluencer, you don't need to be a salesperson?
Well, here's the key. People are tired of the old way of influencing, of blowing your own trumpets, of showing off everything that you've done and maybe have earned.
Your qualifications, your degrees on the wall, all
but
of that.
People are hungry, more hungry than ever, for being influenced. And that is a model that we've developed.
Yes.
That we are practicing on LinkedIn, that we are preaching on LinkedIn. It is all about elevating others, celebrating others, and uplifting others.
And so, in this module 7, you will learn the art of affluencing, the art of building rapport and trust, and the art of taking the deal you've just negotiated through a logical conclusion.